So hi, and welcome to our skill session on video in Microsoft 365. I'm Struan Robertson from the Microsoft Stream Design team, and I'm very happy today to be joined by the wonderful Shagun Bright from our marketing team. Okay, so let's take a look at what we're going to talk about today. Now, the main thing we want you to take away is that Stream is evolving to make video amazing across the whole of Microsoft 365. And we want this session to help you build a foundation of skills that are going to work today, but are also going to set you up for success as Stream evolves. So we've got a bunch of demos today that are going to show you how to use video tools right now. So that's anything from our screen capture tool to using video with your existing SharePoint sites. But before we get into those, we also just wanted to level set a little on how we think about video in the enterprise and how Stream is evolving to meet those challenges. Because it's an incredibly fast-moving world, and sometimes it's kind of hard to figure out where video can be effective or how to make it work for you. Okay. So since last year's Ignite, we've been thinking a lot about what our customers, well, you, all want from video. We talked to something in the region of about 800 of you to really try and get a handle on what people want from video in their organizations. And while obviously there's quite a lot of different answers here, from very tactical things that people want changed in Stream like right now, to kind of more existential questions about video in general, there are three common themes that just continually come up. So the first of those is that people believe that video is key to helping them connect authentically. And honestly, I think this is kind of just obvious, right? If I look at my phone right now, I know for certain that my text messages are either going to have a video of our 9-month-old puppy doing something cute, or, I suppose somewhat differently, a video from my 11-year-old son of him elaborately pummeling somebody in Fortnite. We just use video without thinking in our daily lives, and organizations believe that that habit is crucial to helping their teams connect in the workplace. And then the second thing that you can see on the slide here is that video can really help share knowledge. I'm sure everyone is familiar with videos in this way. Like, way more than a document, a video delivers rich information in a way that works for all kinds of learners. Now, a lot of this content today is like professionally made, but again, if you look at the wider world of video in our daily lives, you see people using all sorts of commercial video platforms to share ideas and short how-to videos. Empowering your organizations to share knowledge with video is key for you, and we totally hear you on that. And then finally, video is incredible at allowing organizations to communicate en masse with their teams. Whether it's hearing from leadership or officially sanctioned training, or even smaller events like team meetings or all hands, like we do that all the time in the Stream team, video brings this more human touch to everyone. Whether someone's out and about with just their mobile, or whether they're sitting staring at a 4K monitor all day, the great thing about video is that it works across all form factors to unite teams behind a common message. And when you look at the numbers behind video, this kind of just backs it up. Human brains process video 60,000 times faster than text. Like, video just, like, hardwired connects to the brain so much more efficiently. It's this universally understood way of allowing people to take in information. And again, if you just look at the number of video learning platforms out there, this kind of seems self-evident. We also see that people are more likely to watch a video than engage in some other types of documents. And again, given how prevalent video is across our lives, this makes sense. People are just used to watching videos that they're sent. And then finally, when people do watch videos, the key thing here is that they retain more information and they're more likely to engage with that content. So if you're out there working employee engagement or communications in your company, that's especially important. And really, that last point is something that I kind of want to dive into a little bit more. Like, video is central to modern communications. Right, today, there is this abundance of content in the workplace. It's quite overwhelming, right? It's all flashing by or requiring our attention. And captivating storytelling is critical to getting your message to rise above the noise, and video is just great at doing that. But even when you have that captivating storytelling, you actually need more than that. You need to be able to target delivery to help you reach the right person at the right time on the right device. And then when you have done that, they need to be able to engage in that conversation and capture feedback. And then finally, once you've done all that, you want to be able to measure the impact of that to make sure you understand like what worked and how you're going to improve things in the future. And that framework like really governs how we think about Stream as it evolves. And our goal is to give you the tools to continually use that framework successfully. And then another thing that we think about as Stream evolves is that within a video, there's this ton of like rich information that can help people be more productive. And right now, a lot of that is locked inside a video file, but our goal is to break open that black box and extract information about chapters or topics or even action items that were mentioned or sentiment or viewing data and just make it so that end users can use those to key in and access the information they need from the video. getting all that richness from the video, but in much less time. But of course, there are challenges that come in any format, right? And so with video, we think about those in four ways. The first of those is creation. A lot of creation tools out there have a level of complexity that's actually like pretty hard and even teeters into the professional end of the spectrum. Then people generally have a bit of a lack of experience, not just with those tools, but also just how to structure a video. Like, how long should you make a video? How do you best tell a story with video? And then because it's a new medium, especially in the workplace, like people are a little bit worried that they're going to get embarrassed by it. Like, they don't like the sound of their own voice. Or they don't like how they look on camera. And then the second part is discovery, right? Searching for videos is hard, especially if they don't have a title or if you can't search directly into the transcript. And then similarly, if videos don't surface in your daily workflows or your feeds like your other documents do, then they won't feel like they're part of everyday work. Distribution and consumption. On that point, like, where do you put videos so that people should see them? You know, you can email things around, but video files tend to be large, and that makes email somewhat complex. And then, of course, we know it's absolutely crucial to our customers to make sure that all of our document types are secure and compliant.
Like Storin just outlined, implementing video can be incredibly challenging without the right solution. We're going to show you some demos that help you speak to those problem areas, and we're going to do so across these three scenarios: authentic communication, improved knowledge sharing, and better engagement. Video can be a great way to authentically communicate. It allows you to express nuance and emotion in a way that text sometimes doesn't, and it doesn't require that everyone is in the same place at the same time. There's a number of ways you can already do that in Microsoft 365 today. Let's take a look at a few of those.
Videos are also a great way of ensuring that your presentations feel polished and professional, or that crucial training presentation you've given is captured for everyone to see at a later date. Let's look at a couple of demos that speak to how that can work.
And finally, let's take a look at how your use of video in the workplace can bring the company closer together and allow leaders to engage with their teams and vice versa. As we said at the start of these demos, hopefully they give you a foundation of skills to help you improve your use of video. Let's now briefly look at how Stream is going to build on that foundation with our vision for the new Stream. This new vision empowers users to create, share, discover, and manage video just as they would any other file. The new Stream enhances video stored in Microsoft 365 and builds on the rich content management features of SharePoint, while at the same time unlocking the intelligence of the Microsoft Graph to deliver long-awaited features including external and anonymous sharing, integration with Microsoft Search, enhanced analytics, improved transcript quality, and new controls for security and compliance. Stream is evolving from these finite sets of experiences to one in which video is more pervasive across any and all experiences. What does that mean? It means, for one, you can organize video your way using the SharePoint tools that are already familiar to you. This means more custom portals and better mixing of different media types. You can also use powerful organizational tools like communities, teams, or even folders, as well as embedding videos across a number of other locations. And we're solving the harder discovery challenges by building a web app in office.com and leveraging the power of Delve and your intranet. Secondly, when it comes to consuming a video, we're making all videos in Microsoft 365 faster and more intelligent. That means everywhere you encounter a video file, whether in a SharePoint library, OneDrive, Teams, or Yammer, you can expect it to work for everyone. And finally, we'll be bringing video creation everywhere, allowing you to use the tools you've seen today and many more to create compelling communications. Having heard all we've shared today, you're probably excited to learn what's next. And for that, we turn to our roadmap. Customers who want to create future-proof video experiences in Microsoft 365 can start building them with SharePoint and the Microsoft Graph today. Coming soon, we'll be bringing CDN support for larger bitrate videos. Teams meeting recordings will be shared in OneDrive and SharePoint to enable, among other features, basic governance, guest and external sharing, and also retention policies for meetings. And finally, we'll be giving you video analytics so you can have greater insights into video consumption and usage. For customers using Classic Stream, we will support you in the coming months with a phased introduction of new features, migration tools, and detailed guidance about the change that's coming. And with that, we've come to the end of this skilling session. Struan and I want to thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you next time. Thank you, and bye-bye.
Thanks. Bye.